Hello friends, in the series on the income tax cases, today we will discuss an issue on condonation. The rule of condonation is that the condonation application of the assessee should be considered liberally. The integrities of getting the refund should not be considered at the time of giving the condonation. If the assessee is able to prove the genuine hardship in not filing the return of income or the revised return of income in time, then the condonation should be allowed. This is the general rule. The principle of condonation has been discussed in the case of Rusti Ol Kumar Shah versus Principal Commissioner of Income Tax. This case has been reported in 470 ITR at page number 229. The date of the judgment is 20th June 2023. The facts of the present case are like this. The concerned assessment year is 2019-20. In the present case, a notice was issued to the assessee under section 139 subsection 9 that the return of the assessee is defective and the assessee has to file its submissions within 15 days. The assessee could not remove the defects in the return of income. The assessee was going through the lockdown period, that is March 2020 to April 2020. The notice was received from the CPC that the assessee has to file the revised return of income under section 139 subsection 5 to remove the defects. But the period for filing the revised return has already expired. The assessee filed condonation application before the Principal Commissioner of Income Tax by saying that there was genuine hardship in not revising the return on time due to COVID pandemic and due to the lockdown during the period March 2020 to April 2020. The Principal Commissioner of Income Tax was convinced that there was genuine hardship on the part of the assessee and allowed the condonation to the assessee. Later on, the Principal Commissioner of Income Tax, who has allowed the condonation to the assessee, felt that he was not having the jurisdiction over the assessee, so he withdrew the condonation application. The assessee do not have any other option just to file the condonation application with his jurisdictional Principal Commissioner of Income Tax, and the assessee filed his condonation with his Principal Commissioner of Income Tax. This time, while reviewing the application of the assessee for condonation, the Principal Commissioner of Income Tax rejected the condonation application by giving the reason that there was no genuine hardship on the part of the assessee in filing the revised return on time, and he rejected the condonation application of the assessee, although the same application was allowed by the earlier Principal Commissioner of Income Tax. The assessee filed a writ petition in the Gujarat High Court. The Gujarat High Court quashed the rejection of condonation and allowed the condonation of the assessee by saying that when the condonation application of the assessee has already been accepted on the issue of genuine hardship, but the same was rejected on the technical grounds that it was allowed by the non-jurisdictional Principal Commissioner of Income Tax, so the same application cannot be rejected by the other Principal Commissioner of Income Tax on the ground that the assessee do not have the genuine hardship. If the department has taken a stand, then that stand should be continued in the case of the assessee. Gujarat High Court also said that the case of the assessee on the merits also falls in favor of the assessee because there was lockdown in the country during the period March 2020 to April 2020. So, in the present set of circumstances, there is a reasonable cause, there is genuine hardship on the part of the assessee, and the condonation application of the assessee should be accepted. Apart from this, the generic law on the condonation is that the condonation application should be considered liberally, and in allowing the condonation or at the time of allowing the condonation, the integrities of the refund should not be taken care by the PCIT. Only the genuine hardship why the returns are delayed should be considered at the time of considering the condonation applications. At the end of this video, once again I am repeating the name of the case. The name of the case is Vrushti Ol Kumar Shah versus Principal Commissioner of Income Tax, and this case has been reported in 470 ITR at page number 229. The date of the judgment is 20th June 2023. Thank you, friends.